I could have easily bought a Homelink module from Tesla to control my garage, but that would just make too much sense. So instead, I decided to make my own. Today's DIY project is my solution for opening and closing a garage door using an existing button in my car. When I started, I was searching for a button to use for unlocking the garage. After a bit of exploration, I found that the right wheel button, which usually activates the voice assistant, could be repurposed without disturbing my driving experience. But before diving into the technical details, I want to outline the flow of events to understand how the components work together to achieve this. It starts with me pressing the wheel. This triggers an event within the car's computer. This event travels within the car and is detected by device, let's call it device A. This device wirelessly transmits all the events it detects to device B. Device B, which is connected to the garage door opener, mimics this press, effectively controlling the garage door opener. So now, let's explore the detailed operations of each of these components. Starting with the brain behind this operation, the bridge, or the gateway. This bridge is responsible for reading the activities that happen in the car by connecting to the car's CAN bus. It's equipped with an ESP32 microcontroller and the shield for the CAN activities, which I made multiple videos about. Each activity it reads from the car, it sends wirelessly, broadcasting it to any device to hear using the ESPNow protocol. This brings us to the second part, the garage door opener device. This device is simply an ESP8266 board, which is a Wemos D1 Mini, with a relay shield connected directly to the garage door opener. This device receives the activities from the CAN bus wirelessly, and it listens to the activity associated with the wheel press. When it detects that the wheel was pressed and held down, it briefly closes and reopens the relay. Again, this essentially mimics the wall mount garage button. Now that we understand the flow, let's go through it again in technical details. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I've been a loyal user of PCBWay for several years, using their services for my DIY project and 3D prints. I'm a big fan of their $5 for 10 pieces promotion, allowing me to experiment without breaking the bank. If you share my passion for DIY project and looking to elevate your creations, consider giving PCBWay a try. You can find a link to their services down below. Now back to the video. Starting from the wheel, when the wheel is pressed, it creates a CAN message on the CAN bus. The ESP32 with the CAN shield also sits on the same bus and is able to read all the CAN messages on that bus, one by one, copying the ID, data, and the length of the data from the CAN message to an ESPNow structure. This structure also has an identifier called the mesh ID, which you can think of it as the car ID, in case I have multiple gateways installed in different cars or even the same car on different CAN buses. The receiver reads the ESPNow messages and optionally verifies it's from the intended car. It then checks the CAN ID and extracts the wheel button status. If the ID matches and the wheel was pressed for a specific period, then your relay is triggered. Now you might think, how did I come up with this ID or know this is part of the associated data for the wheel press? Well, this is how the car manufacturers, in my case Tesla, decided to use it. Deciphering the correct message from the car or the CAN bus is typically time-consuming and manufacturer and sometimes car-specific. Fortunately, DBC files, which are like dictionary files, aid in deciding these messages. For my car, I found a partial DBC file on the Tesla owner's online forum, and through examination, I identified the CAN message I needed. However, there are other resources that you can use to find DBC files for your car, like OpenDBC repo. I was lucky enough to find one, and using it, I was able to identify the ID and data representing the wheel press. Once this particular message is received, I activate the relay, opening the garage. This process works for both opening and closing the garage, provided I am within the range of the garage receiver. It has roughly the same range as Wi-Fi signals, if you're curious. The success of this setup led me to replicate it on my other car. I installed a second gateway in the OBD2 port, which fortunately has access to the CAN bus. I explained this a bit more in my CAN versus OBD2 video. In the Tucson, which is my SUV, I utilized the cruise control button as the trigger. Once again, luck was on my side as there was a DBC file for my SUV, enabling me to identify the correct CAN message. Now I can open the garage using either car, whether by pressing the wheel on the Tesla or the cruise control button on the SUV. It's essential to know that this method isn't a secure way to control a garage door. Someone could monitor my activities, identify the use of ESPNow, intercept the message, and gain access to the garage. This setup prioritizes convenience over security, so that is something to keep in mind. Nevertheless, I hope you found interest in my project. I will link to the resources in the description. And as always, thank you for watching. Until next time, happy tinkering!